welcome to another edition of This Week in Angels Baseball, once again coming to you from the Edison International Field of Anaheim. Now, the Angels' 2003 starting lineup suffered another blow last week when catcher Benji Molina suffered a broken left wrist during a home plate collision during a game against Minnesota. Now, Molina immediately had surgery and is expected to have a full recovery and hopefully be back for spring training in 2004. Now, all of the Angels' injuries this year have had a major impact on the starting lineup and the team, but none may be bigger than that of Molina. With 3 weeks left in the season, the Angels catcher had matched his season high in offensive numbers, hitting .281 with 14 home runs and 71 RBIs. He was also having another gold glove season behind home plate, leading American League catchers in percentage of throwing out would-be base stealers for the second straight year. And of course, the way that Molina handles a starting rotation is invaluable, especially with all the young talent coming up from AAA Salt Lake. Now, manager Mike Socha, a guy who knows a thing or two about catching, recently commented on the loss of his catcher in the latest edition of From the Dugout. Mike, it's not good to see anyone go down with an injury, but when a guy like Benji Molina goes down with the season he was having, that's got to be tough.
It's tough for anybody when they're injured, but I think in Benji's case, he meant so much to our club. He's played so well all year, and to see him go down on a play at the plate, it's tough. But he hangs in there tough when plays at the plate, and that's a risk you take.
Talk about him with plays on the plate, probably one of the toughest guys behind the plate you've seen.
He hangs in there. Benji does a good job. He knows it's the last chance to score a run or save a run, and he wants to do everything he can to try to do it. He just got caught in a little bit of an awkward position. It was really and probably an easier play than any of the other tough plays he's had this year, and it was just a kind of a fluke that not only the ball came out of his glove, but he broke his wrist in the meantime.
Then talk about his development the last couple of years that you've seen. I mean, has he become one of the premier catchers in your opinion?
Yeah, absolutely. I think Benji's gone from a guy that everyone thought that he was a good prospect, but he never really showed in the minor leagues the talent he had. When he got the opportunity up here, he just took off with this job, and he understands what it's about behind the plate, and he knows it's a defensive position. He takes a lot of pride in what he does with the pitching staff, and that's first and foremost to him, and that's one of the big reasons why we won a world championship with him playing. And he's also a good offensive player, so the improvement he's made has been incredible.
Now, with these guys going down, four guys out for the season, how has the clubhouse been? You got a lot of new faces in there right now.
Got a lot of new faces. Like we talked about the other day, we still intend to go out here and win, but we might be winning with different look than maybe people are used to, and you don't know really how you're going to win, but it takes on a different form every night. We got a great group of guys still. We still have a lot of talent we can put out there on the field. We've got some young players who are very aggressive. But it's tough when you're trying to fill the holes of the guys that have been such a big part of this club for many years.
But the excitement level's got to be up with these guys. I mean, everybody wants to get in there, play, and produce.
Well, these guys are excited. I think it's a good atmosphere. I think guys, guys want to come out here and play, and they play the game hard. And hopefully we're going to finish strong because we have the ability to do that. And as long as our pitching will hold up, I think we have a tough ball club.
And thanks again to Mike for joining us. Now next up, we're going to go behind the scenes of Big Bang Friday when This Week in Angels Baseball returns.
College rivalries never die. That's why there's the ESPN Game Plan College Football Pay-Per-View Package. It's all the teams you want to see and all the ones you want to see beaten.
Alcohol and drugs are one threat.
It's like a bottomless pit you're falling into.
Bullying is another.
I was scared of these people because they were all, like, hunting me down.
Cox Communications is connecting with kids and their parents to build character and keep our kids safe and secure. It's called Connect, on the air and in the classroom. Starting in September, watch Connecting with Kids on Cox 3. For a complete schedule, go to cox3.com.
Music Choice presents MusicLink, delivering the thought-provoking and the talented in music and music video to you via your old friend, the television. This month, MusicLink is hosted by Chris from Dashboard Confessional and the boys of Bowling for Soup, and features clips from AFI, The Dandy Warhols, Thrice, and 311. For more great programming, including music and movies, call today and ask about digital cable.
This heat is too much. Finally a breeze.
I'm Jared Washburn, you're watching This Week in Angels Baseball.
And welcome back to the program. Now, fans say it's better than the 4th of July, and those of you who've attended these Angel games know exactly what that means. Heather Hutchins reports.
Minutes of choreographed fireworks leave the audience remembering not just a pyrotechnics show, but a work of art. The company, Pyro Spectaculars, gives fans something to cheer about no matter what the score is.
Friday nights at Anaheim Stadium are special nights because they are the nights that after the game we present a full feature pyrotechnics, a fireworks show that is specially designed for the Angels fan.
Yeah, those are flared. We got the nail gun for those.
Paul's crew spends the better part of a day setting up the extravaganza, but the creative process begins long before that. The under 10-minute show can take 3 days to design, from choosing the effects to programming the computers that are used to ignite the fireworks. But Sousa has the experience to make this show a success. It is, after all, in his blood.
Five generations of the Sousa family have been brightening the night sky with fireworks, and Big Bang Friday at Edison Field is no exception.
I don't think any team does what the Angels do on a regular basis on a Friday. Like, teams have fireworks, but Big Bang Fridays are by far, they're beyond fireworks.
And season ticket holders think so too.
The lights go down and then the fireworks start. It's awesome. It's all you definitely got to stay for the whole game on Friday nights.
Some of them do sparkly stuff and they're really neat to watch.
And that is what Sousa calls the wow factor.
We leave many fans emotional, and the cheers at the end of the show just speak volumes for the wow factor.
Week at Angels Baseball, I'm Heather Hutchins.
This company, Pyro Spectaculars, has done the Super Bowl and is scheduled to do the Olympics in Athens in 2004. Thanks again, Heather, for that report. Now, last weekend, the Angels made their final stop in the 2003 Caravana de los Angels Tour. The sixth and final location of the Caravana was at the Rouse Grocery Store on Lincoln Avenue in Anaheim. The Caravana was a monthly program that took place throughout Orange County, providing Hispanic communities an opportunity to interact with Angels players, coaches, and broadcasters. On hand last Saturday to speak to the fans and sign a few autographs were infielder Alfredo Amezaga, coaches Alfredo Griffin and Orlando Mercado, and Spanish broadcasters Ivan Lora and Jose Molina.
Great job by the Angels and understanding that to be in touch with the Hispanic community, you need to go find them, and they will come find you. And I think the respect that they've shown and reaching out has been superb.
In Mexico, we do the same thing, you know, but not as, like, this big, you know. And also it helps, you know, to bring the Spanish community, you know, to the ball games, which is they know a lot, so I really like them.
This is great, you know, especially now that we have a Latino owner, Arturo Moreno, so, you know, it's going to be a lot of different things that's going to happen in Anaheim, so I'm happy to be part of this.
And great job to all who participated in the Caravana throughout the year. Now Sunday, the World Champion Angels honored the other champions of Orange County, and the Pacifica Girls softball team was there. The Day of Champions put the Lady Mariners down on the field with the Angels players for a pregame ceremony, which included a picture at home plate with Angels GM Bill Stoneman. It was a perfect way to remember a near-perfect season.
And you guys are being honored for your championship run. It just feels really good because it's like we worked so hard and it just all paid off in the end. And it's really neat.
You know, they were just a team-oriented group that there was no real individuals. It was all a team effort. They were all like sisters, and that's I contribute that to our success.
Pacifica won the Division III CIF title, a state championship, and finished second in the nation. Once again, congratulations to the Mariners. Now the minor league report is next when This Week in Angels Baseball returns.
Later.
Hey, where did you get a cell phone?
With Liberty Wireless, all I needed was a valid credit card.
Have you tried to get a cell phone, only to be told you don't qualify or they want a big deposit? Well, not anymore. If you've got a valid credit card today, we can get you a cell phone.
Forget expensive minutes. Forget big deposits. At Liberty Wireless, you get great cell phone service for only $39.99 a month. Like 300 anytime minutes and 1,000 night and weekend minutes to anywhere in the country when calling on the network. Sign up now and get a cell phone and accessories pack for only $29.99 plus shipping and handling. Supplies are limited, so call now. Other great plans available.
Even if those other guys said no, we love to say yes. Liberty Wireless. We put our money where your mouth is.
Call now and get a cell phone and accessories pack for only $29.99 plus shipping and handling. Grab your credit card and call now. Supplies are limited. Call 1-800-985-6075. That's 1-800-985-6075. Call now.
Liberty Wireless, the easy way to get a cell phone.
Own a timeshare? Sell it for cash. Own a campground membership? Sell it for cash. In the last 6 months, over $1 billion in vacation timeshares have been sold industry-wide. Now's the perfect time to buy, sell, or rent your property for cash. Call right now for your free information kit to buy, sell, or rent your timeshare or campground membership for cash. Plus, be one of the next 200 callers, and we'll include 10 secrets to buy or sell your timeshare by Century 21 Vacation Properties. It's only available from this special TV offer. Don't wait until you have to pay another maintenance fee or tax bill. Call now and turn your timeshare into cash. Be one of the next 200 callers for your free information kit, and we'll include 10 secrets to buy or sell your timeshare by Century 21 Vacation Properties. Buy, sell, or rent your timeshare for cash. Call now. Don't wait to pay another maintenance fee or tax bill. It's a free call, so call now. Call 800-218-7869. That's 800-218-7869 for this limited time exclusive TV offer.
That one's on the dance floor, boys.
Oh, looks like you're buying dinner tonight, GA.
What is that?
32 ounce.
I'm Brendan Donnelly, and you're watching This Week in Angels Baseball.
And welcome back to the program. Now in 2003, Quakes first baseman Casey Kotchman continued to show all the tools of a big league player despite battling injuries through his second professional season with the Angels organization. Casey Kotchman now joins us in the latest edition of the Minor League Report.
I think you can just learn from each day you come to the field and you try to get the most out of each day that you have because you're just trying to improve each and every day.
And Casey Kotchman has tried to improve each day despite being plagued by injuries for a good part of the 2003 season. The 20-year-old first baseman started the year red hot, leading the team in batting average, home runs, and on-base percentage through the first 28 games of the season before a hamstring injury forced him to the disabled list two times, the second covering a period from May 27th to August the 4th. When he finally came off the DL, fellow teammates Dallas McPherson, Jeff Mathis, and Nick Gourneau had all been promoted to AA Arkansas, a place Kotchman might have been if he stayed healthy.
Try not to, you know, worry about stuff I can't control, and you can't really always control what happens to you. You just control how you respond to what happens.
Kotchman finished the regular season hitting .350 with 8 home runs and 28 RBIs in 57 games, once again demonstrating the skills that made him the organization's number one draft pick back in 2001.
He does everything really well. He has a knowledge of the game that's really good for a 20-year-old. Like I said, a solid approach at the plate. So you just hope that that just continues to progress as the games pile up and he gets to more repetitions from experiencing more game time situations.
It's hard to imagine that Casey's skill and knowledge of the game won't progress when his father is Tom Kotchman, a manager in the Angels organization for the last 20 years. But when they talk, baseball is the last thing discussed.
I talk to him quite a bit, but most of the time I talk to him is just talking to Dad, talking to Pop. So we don't talk baseball, you know, too much.
No, I'm not going to coach him. That's for someone else to do. We just talk a lot and give him support. And if he asks me about certain things, and give him my opinion. But other than that, just try to be Dad.
But Dad does have some great advice.
He's always heard me tell the kids, you know, wear a uniform as long as you can if he's getting a real job. So, you know, he hasn't had to get a real job yet.
Thanks to Casey and his dad for joining us. Now let's take a quick trip around the minor league, starting with AAA Salt Lake. And the Stingers lost 10 of their last 12 games to miss the playoffs. Stingers set a franchise record for stolen bases with 145 and fewest home runs with 106. Sean Figgins set a career triples mark with 33 for the last two seasons. Stingers end the year at 68-75 in third place in the PCL. Moving on to AA Arkansas, and the Travelers ended the season with a 33-37 second half finish in third place. Jake Weber, the outfielder, finishes the league's leading hitter with a 302 average and was the only Arkansas player selected to the Texas League postseason All-Star team. Now moving on to Rancho Cucamonga, where the Quakes are involved in the Cal League playoffs. They dropped their second game to the 66ers, 10-4. Tim Bittner picked up his first loss since joining the Angels after that trade with the Chicago White Sox. Then Rancho Cucamonga came back on Monday night, defeating the 66ers 8-4, but would then fall in game number 4, 7-5 on Tuesday, losing the best-of-five series 3-1 to end their season. In Cedar Rapids, the Colonels ended the second half of the season with a record of 34-35, good enough for sixth place. Eric Ibar and Alberto Callaspo were named the Midwest League postseason All-Star team, and Callaspo finished as the league leader in batting average with a .327 mark, hits with 168, runs scored with 86, and doubles with 38. And finally, ending up with Provo, the Angels involved in the Pioneer League playoffs. They rebounded from a series opening loss to the Ogden Raptors with a 20-5 pounding behind two grand slams, one hit by shortstop Brandon Wood, the other by third baseman Matt Brown, who also drove in seven runs in the game. On Monday, Provo would then go on to beat Ogden 6-1. They won the best of three series 2-1, and they advanced to the Pioneer League finals against Billing starting on Wednesday. And there's much more to come when This Week in Angels Baseball returns.
Tangled up in all that yard work? Break free with the revolutionary new flat hose, based on the same technology that's been used for years on fire hoses. With flat hose, simply turn on the water and watch it expand for a full, unobstructed flow. Just turn off the water and it goes back to its flat shape. So watering your plants or washing the car has never been easier. Stop struggling to rewind ordinary heavy wet hoses. Call now, and as a special bonus, we'll include the flat hose storage reel. Flat hose winds up easily without twisting. You'll also receive this adjustable flow spray attachment. Flat hose, convenient storage reel, and adjustable spray gun. A $50 value, just $19.99. So which would you rather have, this or this? Ask our operators how you can receive the Flat Hose Deluxe Sprayer with special chamber for adding soap or fertilizer. Order your flat hose now.
To order your flat hose, call 800-588-2992.
Take a closer look. Cox Digital Cable brings you more sports action.
You think you're ready to ride with me?
What about that for a finish?
Digital makes the difference.
Thank you. Hi, this is Bud Black. Please tune in to This Week in Angels Baseball.
And welcome back. Now, new Angels owner Artie Moreno and GM Bill Stoneman have both said that there are going to be a lot of changes during the offseason, a change from last year when the only big acquisition was outfielder Eric Owens. Owens filled a void when Orlando Palmeiro left during free agency for the St. Louis Cardinals. And though he struggled for most of the season, Owens has started to see more playing time due to all those Angels injuries, and he started to find his swing. As a matter of fact, in August, he hit .385. Now Owens talks about his role on the Angels and his outlook for next season during the latest edition of the Halo Spotlight. Eric, month of August, very good to you. Found your swing, it looked like. What were you doing differently in that month to get your average to go up a little bit?
Well, I think I started getting some balls to fall that didn't fall at the beginning of the year, and I was starting to get more playing time. I think it all started clicking when we had, unfortunately, the day-night doubleheader in Cleveland, where I got to play back-to-back games, and then I got to play Sunday also. And I was I'm a big-time timing type of guy. And I really started getting some timing back then. And like I said before, I mean, some balls I wasn't hitting on the nose, they were finding holes. And the balls that I was hitting on the nose, they were finding holes also.
Are you still getting the playing time you want? Because you're having a lot of guys coming up from AAA, and it looks like almost a carousel out there in the outfield right now. Are you still getting the time that you want?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, you know, obviously this is a time of year where you're going to look at young guys. You're going to see what guys can do. But Mike's been really good with me recently, especially recently. I mean, even when I'm getting to play, I'm in there using for the whole nine innings, and that's all you can ask for. And, you know, when lefties are out there on the mound, usually I'm getting to play, and just as today. So I can't ask for any more, and I'm just glad that I did get hot when I did. So now when there is all these guys up here, that at least my name is mentioned in the lineup.
Talk to me about next season. What's going through your head? Where do you want to be? Is this a team that you feel that you can fit into next year?
I definitely think it is a team that I can fit into. And it's not a matter of, I haven't been grumpy about my role all year. I mean, there is a role, and you got to know your role. And a lot of young guys who come up have problems with that. And I did, too. As a young guy coming up, I thought I should be out there playing every day. But, you know, sometimes you got to take a step back and say, you know, I want to play for a championship type team. And this is what this team needs on the bench, as well as guys out there playing every day. So I'd love to be back here. I mean, I love Southern California. I played for the Padres for 3 years. So I feel like I'm more of a Southern California guy than anywhere else in the country.
Now, when we talked at the beginning of the season, you mentioned new team, pressing a little bit, trying to make an impression. As the season went on, are you feeling comfortable kind of with your role on this team, with the guys and with your surroundings here?
Well, the guys here are awesome. It's the best clubhouse I've been involved with, from the coaching staff, from Mike Socha all the way down to the bullpen coach, to the players that are playing, to the players that are on the bench. It's the best. And you never saw anybody point any fingers or anything, even when we're losing this year. And that's the greatest part about a clubhouse, because that's very easy to do when you're not winning. When you're winning, everything comes together just fine. No one is griping about anything. But even when we were losing, you never saw anybody pointing fingers. And that's one of the reasons I'd love to be back here.
Every ball player wants to be an everyday guy. And I know you had that with the Marlins for a while. Is that something you still want to do? And do you see yourself possibly working into something here?
Well, I don't maybe foresee it as here or anywhere else where someone has a chance to win a championship. Because I am the type of guy that can come in and play one or two days, 3 days a week. Could I play every day? Yes. I feel like I'd go to Detroit or somewhere like that and play every day and put up numbers. But it's not really about the numbers anymore. Is I want to get a ring, and I want to get into postseason. I haven't been able to experience that here at the major league level. And that was the reason why I chose to come over here during the offseason to Anaheim, because I thought they had a really good chance to go to the postseason. I really think we would have had a great chance to go to the postseason had we had everybody healthy.
Thanks to Eric for joining us. Now, Owens has played in 100 games this season, hitting .256 with one home run and 19 RBIs. Now let's take a quick look at some Halo news and notes. Ramon Ortiz is back in the Dominican Republic. His father passed away after a long battle with emphysema. Called up from AAA was Chris Buchek. He actually made his first big league start on Tuesday, went 3 1/3 innings, giving up 8 runs on 7 hits and giving up 3 home runs. David Eckstein activated from the disabled list on September the 9th, and Tim Salmon has been suffering from some lower back stiffness, spending more time in that DH role. Now let's take a quick look at what's on tap for your Halos. September the 8th through the 11th, Anaheim is at Oakland, then they travel to Seattle September the 12th through the 14th, and finally end up back in Anaheim on September 15th through the 17th. And that just about does it for the program, but we do want to leave you with some information. First, phone number if you need to get a hold of the Angels for any reason. Second, we have a few ways to get a hold of us. A phone number, email address, and also a webpage, adelphiachannel.com. If you want to get a hold of us for any reason, find out where you can view this program throughout Southern California. Once again, thanks so much for tuning in. We'll see you next week right here on This Week in Angels Baseball. So long, everyone, from Edison Field.
I'm Angel Zayoki.